Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can extend the functionality of Thunar File Manager with custom actions, which basically allow you to execute shell commands with a single mouse click. I'll cover a few practical examples that you might find useful in your daily workflow, such as manipulating PDF files and converting multimedia between different formats. Before I begin, I'd like to let you know that this video has chapters, so feel free to skip to the part you're interested in. And now, let's get right into it. To get started with creating your own custom actions, open up Thunar and from the menu toolbar select Edit, Configure Custom Actions. Here you can see the list of your already existing actions, as well as a small toolbar that allows you to manage them. Let's take a look at this example action by selecting it and clicking this cog icon right here. This opens a new window that allows you to edit the selected action. First, we have a name box, so whatever you type here will be displayed when you right-click on a file to open the context menu. Next, we have a description field, where you can briefly describe what your action does. Right underneath it is a submenu box. This one basically allows you to nest multiple custom actions into one submenu, which I'll cover later in one example. Now, here we have a command box, which is the most important one, as here you would type the shell command that you want to execute upon clicking. You can also assign a keyboard shortcut for each custom action, which I think is pretty handy. And finally, you can also add an icon that will display next to the name of your custom action. Obviously, the icons that you can see here depend on what icon package you have installed on your system, so if you want to change it, you can always do so. So now let's quickly go over the second tab. This is where you specify file types which your custom action can be executed on. So for example, if you are making a custom action for converting audio files, you would just select this radio button right here. And if you want to be more specific, you can narrow it down by typing audio formats in this file pattern box. So for example, you could use .mp3, then you could add something like .wave, and so on. The asterisk in front of the file extension tells the shell to match any character. So in simple terms, it means any file that name ends with .mp3 or any file that name ends with .wave. Alright, so now that you know the basics, let's create our first custom action by opening the configuration window and hitting on this plus icon right here. First, we're going to make an action for converting various document types to PDFs. Let's give it a name, convert to PDF. And now we're going to write the command. There are a few different utilities that you can use to convert documents. For example, you can use LibreOffice, MuPDF, or Pandoc. Personally, I'd recommend you to use the first command, since there's a great chance LibreOffice is already installed on your system. Anyway, here's the command that we're going to use. Let me just make this window a little bigger. Now we can select the icon that's going to represent our custom action. So let's look for something relevant, like PDF. And this one looks pretty good. I'm going to select it and hit OK. And now let's navigate to the Appearance Conditions tab, select Other Files. And let's specify some document formats that we would like to convert. So definitely Microsoft Word documents. So let's type .doc and .docx. You probably also want to use Open Document format for LibreOffice. So let's add that as well. You might also want to convert PowerPoint presentations. So let's add .pptx and .ppt. And finally, let's also add .odp for LibreImpress presentations. Just make sure to separate all file extensions with a semicolon. And now we're done. Click OK, and let's test our custom action. I have a few different documents right here. You can see I have one Microsoft Word document, one LibreOffice document, and one PowerPoint presentation. Now let's select them all, right-click, and here you can see our custom action. Let's click on it. Give it a while. And as you can see, three PDF files have been created. Let's verify them by opening them. This one is for, I believe, the Word document. Yep. Now this one is for the LibreOffice document. And this one is a PowerPoint presentation. So as you can see, everything works as expected. Now let's create some custom actions for rotating PDF files. For this, we're going to use the QPDF utility, so make sure to install it first. Once you're done, click the plus icon right here. And since we're going to make three of these actions, we're going to nest them all into one submenu, which we're going to name Rotate. Let's also give this action a name, right? And now here's the command that we're going to use. Let me also make this window a little bigger so you can see. Let's also select some nice icon for our action. So we're going to use the same one as previously. And now let's go to the Appearance Conditions tab, select Other Files, and type .pdf here to make sure that it only works for PDFs. Hit OK, and now we're going to repeat the process two more times, except that we're going to slightly change the command every time. So once again, click the plus icon, and this time we're going to make a command that will rotate our PDFs to the left. We're going to use the same command as before, except that we're going to replace the plus sign with the minus. The submenu name will stay the same, so rotate, and the name of our action will be left. Let's also quickly select an icon. We're going to use the same one, so application PDF. And now let's go to the Appearance Conditions tab and repeat the process. So select Other Files and add the PDF extension in the File Pattern field. Click OK and let's repeat this process one more time. This time we'll replace the value of 90 in our command with 180. Let's add it to the Rotate submenu and let's give it a name of Upside Down. Once again, let's navigate to the second tab, select Other Files, add the PDF extension. I'm also going to add the icon once again, hit OK, and now it's time to test our custom actions. As you can see, here are the PDF files that we have created before. Let's select one of them, right click, and here you can see our submenu. When you hover over it, you have all your custom actions. So let's try rotating this one right, click on it, and as you can see, now it is flipped 90 degrees to the right. We can also click on it once again, and this time rotate it to the left. Sometimes when you do that, Thunar bugs out and you don't see your file, but don't worry, you can just hit Ctrl R to refresh and it's all right. Your file is still here. And now let's test the last custom action by right clicking on this file, rotate and select upside down. And as you can see, it works. The last action for working with PDF files that we're going to make will allow us to merge multiple PDFs into a single one. We're also going to use the QPDF utility for this one, so if you installed it in the previous step, you're good to go. So once again, let's click the plus button and let's give our action a name, merge PDFs. Now let's navigate to the command field and enter this command right here. Let's also choose an action for our command, because why not? It looks more interesting this way. So we're going to select the same one as before. And finally go to the second tab, add the PDF extension to the file pattern box and select other files. Let's click OK and see how our action works. Here I've got some pages from Fusion 19 manual. As you can see, these are just single pages in PDF format. Now I'm going to select all of them, right click and select merge PDFs. And as you can see, a new PDF file has been created that contains all of the single pages that we selected. Quick note that the page order is determined by the names of your files. Usually when you scan documents, the scans are created with names like scan01, scan02, and so on. So this wouldn't be a problem in such situation. But if you need to merge your documents in a different order, you should consider adding numbers in front of their file names, or maybe making your own custom action for renaming files based on their creation time. Thunar is a great file manager, but one thing that I dislike about it is the way it displays metadata of media files. Here I have a video of my cat, and when I play it with MPV and hit I on my keyboard for additional information, you can see that there is a video codec here, which is H.264. There's also information about the frame rate, video resolution. You can also see the audio codec, which is AAC, the bitrate, and so on. A lot of useful information. Now, when you open Thunar, right-click on a video and select Properties. Thunar just says that this is an MPEG-4 video, which only refers to the container type and not the actual video codec. This means that you would get the same information for videos that were encoded with H.265 or AV1. To fix this, we're going to create a custom action that displays more information about multimedia files. For this, we're going to use the FFProbe utility, which comes with the FFmpeg package. It should already be installed on your system, so we don't have to worry about any additional steps. Alright, so once again, let's open the configuration window. Hit the plus button to add a new action, and let's give it a name, media info. Let's also select some nice icon for our action. I think I'm going to look for something like video, and I think this one looks pretty cool, so I'm going to go with it. And now here's the command that we're going to use to fetch the metadata of media files. We'll also want this data to be displayed to us, so we're going to execute this in a terminal window. Since I'm using Foot as my terminal emulator, I'm just going to add foot-H in front of this command. But since you're probably using something different, here you can see the list of commands that you should use depending on your terminal emulator of choice. Now let's navigate to the Appearance Conditions tab, select Audio Files and Video Files, hit OK, and now we're going to see how it works. Here I've got the video from before, now I'm going to right-click on it and select Media Info. And as you can see, the output isn't too pretty, but you can see all video and audio streams that are inside the file. You can see both the video and audio codecs of each stream. You also can see the bit rates, resolution, frame rate, and so on. So this one is pretty useful if you work with video files. If you would like a cleaner output, you could try customizing the command so that it only displays information you're interested in. But for me, it's okay the way it is, so I'm going to leave it like that. Now we're going to create a custom action for converting PNG images to JPEGs. You might find this one useful if you want to share a high quality PNG with your friend on Discord, but then you get hit with the 10 megabytes limit, or if you just simply want to save as much disk space as you can. Okay, so let's make a new action by clicking the plus button, and let's give it a name, convert to JPEG. I'm also going to select some icon. I'm going to search for something like image, and let's see. I think I like this one, so I'm going to go with it, hit OK, and now here's the command that we're going to use. This command makes use of the Image Magic utility, which also should be already installed on your system, so we don't have to worry about getting it. You can also feel free to change the quality value if you like, but I think that going with something like 90 or 95 is usually the best. Finally, let's go to the Appearance Conditions tab, select Image Files, and in the File Pattern field, let's add a PNG extension, hit OK, and let's see it in action. So let's say that I just found this nice wallpaper that I want to share with my friend. And as you can see, the file is 15 megabytes large, so when I try to send it on Discord, I will get this message that this file exceeds the size limit, yada yada, give us your money and whatever. And now when I select this file, right click on it and select convert to JPEG, you can see that a new JPEG file is created that is only 3 megabytes large, and now I can upload it to Discord, no problem. And I'm also going to show you the two of them now, so you can see if you notice any quality difference. Anyway, let's continue with the video. Finally, let's create a custom action for converting WAV audio files to OPUS format. Keep in mind that since we're converting from a lossless format to a lossy one, we will inevitably lose some quality in exchange for reduced file size, but the difference may not be too noticeable depending on your encoding settings. Once again, let's start by clicking this plus icon to create a new action, and in the name box, let's type convert to OPUS. I'm also going to select some icon for this action to make it look a bit nicer. So let's search for audio and see what we got here. I like this generic one, so I'm going to select it and hit OK. And now let's navigate to the command window and enter the following command. This command will automatically select the target bitrate for the output file, but if you want, you can specify it yourself with -b argument. You can also use -vbr if you want to use variable bitrate. And if you want to read up on all the options, I'll put a link to the OPUS page from FFmpeg documentation in the description, so feel free to check it out. Anyway, now let's navigate to the second tab. Select audio files, and in the file pattern field type .wav. Now click OK, and let's see how it works. I've got a copyright-free song right here that's in the WAV format. Let's right-click it, and select convert to OPUS. And as you can see, a new audio file in the OPUS format has been created. I'm going to mix the playback of both of these files right now, so you can see if you hear any difference in quality. Depending on the size of your audio file, it might take a bit longer to complete the conversion process, so I'm going to show you a cool tip right now. Let's open the configuration window once again. Make sure to select our action and click on this cog icon right here. Now let's go to the command field, and after the command, add two ampersands, then type notify-send, and within two quotation marks, type something like conversion finished. The two ampersands that we've added basically tell the shell to execute the second command only if the first one was finished. And the second command sends you a desktop notification that says conversion finished. If you want, you can make it look even better by adding an icon to your notification by adding -i as an argument and then specifying a path to an SVG file. Since I'm using Papyrus as my system icon package, I'm just going to enter this path right here. If you're not sure what path you should provide here, you can first check what icon theme is your system using. Then you can navigate to the folder with these icons and use the search function to look for something you like. And then you should be able to see the path to that icon in your file manager. Anyway, now let's click OK. And I'm going to delete that OPUS file from before. And let's try converting this WAV file once again. So let's click Convert to OPUS. And as you can see, we get a cool desktop notification. By using FFmpeg, you can also convert videos, but personally, I wouldn't recommend you to do it with custom actions because this process takes a lot more time and it gets tedious to just manually click through these files. This solution might be fine if you want to convert a single video once in a blue moon, but if you're someone who often encodes multiple videos in batches, then a better idea would be to write a bash script that automates that process. I managed to write such script for myself, even though I don't have any experience with programming. As you can see, I even integrated it into my waybar, so when I hover over it and click, it will ask me what encoder I would like to use, so I can say something like AV1, and it will tell me that there are currently no videos in the queue because I don't have any, but if I had some videos that I wanted to convert, then the script would proceed to encode them one by one. If you would like to see a video on this topic, let me know down in the comments, and I might share some tips with you. As you can see, custom actions are powerful tools that can save you some time by executing shell commands with a single click. I've used Thunar in this video because even though it isn't the most popular file manager, it provides a nice graphical tool for creating custom actions, which makes it a friendly option for beginners or people who just prefer to use GUI. But even if you don't use Thunar as your file manager, you still should have the option to create custom actions. For example, in Dolphin you have service menus, and aside from having the ability to create your own, you also have access to those created by other users, which you can easily install directly from your file manager. If you use Linux Mint, then the default file manager for this distribution is Nemo, which also gives you the ability to create Nemo actions, as well as to install the existing ones from the official add-ons repository. And if you happen to use GNOME File Manager, also known as Nautilus, you still have the ability to execute custom scripts, even though it's not kinda the same as custom actions. So if you don't use Thunar and you still clicked on this video for some reason, in the description on this video you can find links to resources on how you can create your own custom actions depending on your file manager of choice. Anyway, thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, feel free to post them down in the comments. And I'll see you guys later.